Edo State gubernatorial election is drawing closer.
Edo State people are in the verge of taking a decision that will make or mar their lives in the next 4 years.
We are still talking politics. And my name is Esetonia Inambo. This is Hero TV. Today I have someone to tell us how and why they think that Edo State people should vote in Obaseki for the second term. Thank you for being a part of us today.
It's a pleasure. I am Honorable Pastor Hastin Ogbebo, the leader of the legislative arm, Esan West.
All right, so Edo State gubernatorial election is drawing closer. There are tension everywhere as who will be the winner. So why do you think Edo State people should vote for Obaseki?
I'm so optimistic that Obaseki will come the second time because of his good work. As you can see, I'm no longer a small boy. I've seen series of elections be conducted in this state. During campaigns like this, I've never seen anyone like Obaseki that have pulled such a crowd in every home, in every family. Obaseki is there. In a family of 10, you have 8 Obaseki. Even the 8 will be fighting against their parents, telling them what they are doing against Obaseki is wrong. I've never seen it this way before. It's only God that can do this. And as a pastor, I know the revelations I received concerning this. And I've decided to join Obaseki for this good work. Because the Bible says, do not be weary in well-doing. In due season, you will reap if you faint not. And I believe that is what Obaseki is doing. Obaseki definitely is doing something that generations and generations are born will enjoy. Like our amiable father in politics of his blessed memory, Ambrose Ali. It was because of, I went to school very old, and it was because of Ambrose Ali I was able to enjoy that benefit. My parents were not having money to send me to school, but Ambrose Ali did that for me. And I've heard it from Obaseki. He said, the governor I want to be like is Governor Ambrose Ali. So I believe that is the reason why a lot in Esan West, APC has never won an election in Esan West, apart from this immediate past election where we did for our honorable member for House of Assembly. Every other election is PDP. So I've come to join a good family.
Okay, that means you decamped from APC to PDP.
I decamped with all that God has given me.
All your subordinates.
You know, my subordinates to join them. Because when you see people say this one resigned, commissioner resigned, you ask them, how many people are following commissioner? Then a lot of us that decamp from APC to PDP, we decamp in hundreds, in 50s. But when you see one, what do they call them? One SSA, we say decamp. You see everybody, all the leaders in APC will come and surround that person. That if I have decamp, it would have been a celebration in my ward that the leader has decamp. But I want to address my people not to be carried away by Commissioner Decamp, this one Decamp. They don't have anybody following them. Obaseki has become a household name. I'm encouraging my people. All my people will come out to vote. I am coming out with my family. We are coming to vote. I want to use the opportunity to tell people not to happen like our people, the talker. Nobody is coming to fight anybody. They are just saying mouth talk. I don't believe they have gone to shoot. We are brothers. Like in my place where I came from, the people from APC and people from BDB, we are of the same household. How will my brother come and kill me? How will I carry gun to go and shoot my brother? It's not possible.
There have been this allegation of fighting, talks, destroying things, shooting everywhere. So how come about that?
If they don't do that, because they don't, you see, there are 2 ways to politics. You must do grig-grig-grag-grag like that to scare people away so that they will not come out on voting day. But with this good work you are doing, we are telling the people to come out in numbers and vote. Mm. Nobody should be afraid. Mm. The federal government is coming with enough security not to support any political party. The security body in the states, and we are joining our hands together to work. God is on our side. I am praying, they are praying. Recently, the CP was here, he's going around trying to do a kind of peace talk. In the village where I came from, they are doing a peace talk. It's going on, and I believe our children should be wise enough. Anybody that's giving them a gun to go and fight during election, their children are in America, in Europe, in other places. It's because they are not too educated. That's why they are listening to them. If you want somebody to shoot gun, you go and bring your son or your daughter
to come
and shoot gun.
Yes.
Not bringing another person's child.
Yeah.
I knew what it takes me to come to the level where I am.
Yeah.
So nobody can encourage me to go and shoot another person. And after shooting your brother, then election is done and it's gone. Where, and people know you are the one that did that to your people, where are you going to survive it? It's going to be another problem on you. So I believe that this work you are doing is a good one.
So actually we need to sensitize the people.
The people.
Few days from now, we'll be having the election.
Yeah.
And the next 10 or 11 days, we'll know who the winner is.
Yeah.
So we're still looking at, whatever we are looking for is how to make Edo State better. You know, we're talking about the ESA agenda, you know. Aside that, presently, how many ESAN people does Governor Obaseki has in his cabinet?
Like now, as it is from the hierarchy, we have the governor in Edo South, the deputy in Edo North, the speaker in Edo Central. Okay, that is the hierarchy as it is right now.
Okay.
Like my ward was 7, we have a commissioner.
Okay.
In so many other places, I'm not talking about SAs and SSAs. I'm not talking about the women empowerment. I'm not talking about, you see, the way Governor Obaseki is affecting us, the Eastern people, we are privileged to have him. Obaseki has done more than what I know to say. During this campaign, I got to know that women, Eastern women in government, there are so many. As I'm talking to you now, Obaseki has not given me a dime.
Okay, so you mean that because we have a lot of people coming out to converse vote for Obaseki, that those people are doing it voluntarily?
A lot are doing it voluntarily because they can see a good work. I must confess it to you that one leader once told me that, na road I go chop. A leader. It's one of the reasons I'm staying with Obaseki. A time is coming that if we have a governor like this, Obaseki again, and somebody like Obaseki comes up, people that don't like staying with salary will not contest again. Some of us are doing this church work not because of money. We are doing it because God asks us to do it. The same calling for politics, for ministry work, very soon is going to happen for politics. When there is no enough of it, a lot of people, what am I going there to do? It's no longer as usual. It's no longer Ghana must go. Then they have to pack out. I'm enjoying that.
Right. Thank you, Honorable Hastings Ogbebo. Honorable Hastings Ogbebo has been talking to us the reason, the need to vote for Governor Godwin Obaseki in his second term bid. Okay, election is not a do-or-die affair. It's already countdown to Edo State 2020 gubernatorial election. Go out to exercise your votes. And vote and go back to your houses. Keep watching Hero TV. My name is Cecitonia Inabo. Bye.